Question number 4. In question number 4, there are two equal forces are there. Each magnitude is given as a P. And these two equal forces are acting at a point. And in this question, we need to calculate the angle between the two forces. Let us say the angle between the two forces I am assuming as theta. So to calculate this angle, there was given some conditions. The first condition is, if the resultant is P, then what is the angle between the two forces? This was the first question. The second question, the condition is, if the resultant is P by 2, then what is the angle between the two forces? Again, I am repeating the question. There are two equal forces are there. Each magnitude is P acting at a point, and in this question we need to calculate angle between the two forces. Let us, I am assuming as a theta. In the first question, the condition is, if the resultant is P, then what is the angle between the two forces? If the resultant is P by 2, then what is the angle between the two forces? Before attempting any question, you need to recollect some of the assumptions. So here the assumptions I considered as magnitude of these two forces is not changes with respect to time, as well as angle between the two forces is also not changes with respect to time. Then if you look at the application, just by reading the question, if the two equal forces are acting at a point, then there will be application of parallelogram law. According to parallelogram law, R square is given as P square plus 2PQ cos theta. This is Q. So if we assume these two forces are equal in magnitude P and P, then here P, then here also P, then here P into P, P square will come. Let us say, we'll substitute. According to the first question, the resultant is also P. Substitute here, P square is equal to P square plus 2 times of P into P, P square cos theta. Here you will get theta as 120 degrees. If you solve this equation, you will get theta as 120 degrees. But if you look at the diagrammatic representation, this is one force having magnitude P. This is another force which is having the same magnitude P. These two are separated by an angle 120 degrees. We already know the resultant is always falls in between these two. And here, the resultant is given as P according to the first question. If you solve the second one, then the condition is resultant is P by 2. Substitute here, P by 2 whole square is equal to, again, P square plus 2 times of P into Q, P square cos theta. Here theta you will get 151 degree. If you solve this equation, there you will get theta as 151 degree. But if you look at the diagrammatic representation, this is one force magnitude P. This is another force magnitude P. The angle between these two is given as 151 degree. We calculate it now. The resultant is always in between these two forces. The magnitude is P by 2. Just if you are able to remember this formula, easily we can solve this question. But the point is, what you can observe from this question, observations. So thus assumptions, observations will vary from person to person. According to me, I observed some points. The first point is, without changing the magnitude of these two forces, if the angle increases, If the angle increases, if the angle increases, the resultant will decrease. The first point. The angle decreases, the resultant will increase, and vice versa. The first point. One more observation. If you look at the first diagrammatic representation here, if you add a force that is exactly opposite to resultant, the same magnitude P, there this will be 120 degree, here also 120 degree you will get, so here also 120 degree you will get. Keep it in mind, the force that we added to make the system equilibrium, the force that we added to make the system into equilibrium can be called as equilibriant. One more question you may get, and the point you can understand, if the three equal forces are separated by equiangular distance, then it will make an equilibrium situation. Again, I am telling, three equal forces are separated by equiangular distances will make an equilibrium situation. So three equal forces has to be separated by 120 degree 120 degree 120 degree. Three equal forces at equiangular distances will make an equilibrium situation. And one more observations we can take. We already know the resultant is always falls in between the two forces, but here these two forces are equal in magnitude. This is the reason why the resultant will fall exactly mid, that is at a distance of 60 degree. And here also 151 divided by 75.5 degree. So the point, again I'm telling, if the two equal forces are acting at a point and separated by an angle theta, then the resultant will fall exactly middle, that means at a theta by 2, between two equal forces resultant will fall at middle. Mathematical expression is alpha exactly equal to theta by 2. And from this, one note point also we can do. A note point. The note point is, at a point there are two equal forces P and P. The angle between these two forces is given as theta. There the resultant is given as R square is equal to P square plus 2 times of P into Q, P square cos theta. So here if you common P, P square plus P square, 2 times of P square, 2 times of P square I common, 1 plus cos theta. From trigonometry, 1 plus cos theta can be written as 2 cos square theta by 2. From trigonometry, 1 plus cos theta can be written as 2 cos square theta by 2. Here 2 times of 2, 4 p square cos square theta by 2. So this will be r square. Then r is given as 2 times of under root of p square is given as a p, under root of 4 is given as a 2, under root of cos square theta by 2 is given as cos theta by 2. So from this, one of the gate question was asked for 2 marks. If theta is given as 60 degree. Then resultant is given as, since theta is 60 means the angle between the two forces is 60 degree. Theta by 2 means subtract out here 30, 2 times of P multiplied by cos 30 is given as root 3 by 2. So from this 2, 2 gets cancelled out. Root 3 times of P will be the correct answer. If theta is 90 degree, the resultant is 2 times of P cos theta by 2. 90 by 2 means 45. Cos 45 is given as 1 by root 2. So here you will get a root 2 times of P will be the correct answer. Like this one note point you may take. Keep it in mind, the assumptions, observations will vary from person to person. So here, these are the observations I noticed, and this is one of the note points you need to remember.